lithium-sulfur batteries were once kind of a joke. The chemistry is so unstable and unreliable that no one took them seriously. But now? Well, multiple research teams have recently made strides in transforming sulfur from stinky stone to capable cathode. Some claim to have cracked the code, creating prototypes that charge faster than you can finish this video, and others that last 25,000 cycles. That's basically a forever battery. So what's changed? And could lithium sulfur actually overthrow lithium ion as the king of batteries? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. This video is brought to you by Saley. Not too long ago, we talked about lithium sulfur batteries and a breakthrough from Drexel University around monoclinic gamma phase sulfur. No, not an angry green monster sulfur, but a rare form that sidesteps the polysulfide problem, a flaw that has long kept lithium sulfur batteries from reaching their full potential. And polysulfides? Well, you'll be hearing a lot about those today, so put a pin in that. Since then, lithium sulfur research has taken off. We'll be getting into each of these in more detail. In Australia, the University of Adelaide developed an electrocatalyst that could slash charging times to just 5 minutes. It's a huge leap from 1 to 10 hours typical of a lithium sulfur battery today. Over at Monash University, researchers took inspiration from an unexpected source, an antiseptic mainstay of surgical prep, to push lithium sulfur closer to real-world EV use. And in South Korea, DGIST has also joined the race, unveiling a lithium sulfur battery that can charge in 12 minutes. And to top it off, a recent Nature paper by an international team showcased an all-solid-state lithium-sulfur battery with an almost unbelievable 25,000-cycle lifespan that still holds 80% of its capacity. Now, with game-changing potential for EVs, drones, and consumer electronics, lithium-sulfur could actually challenge lithium-ion's dominance. But if lithium-sulfur is so promising, why hasn't it taken over yet? Well, to answer that, let's dig into the technology itself. Sulfur is dirt cheap, abundant, and safer than other cathode materials like cobalt and nickel, which already gives it a leg up. There's no nightmarish supply chain bottlenecks here, and while sulfur might smell like rotten eggs, the EPA assures us it poses very little, if any, risk to human health. It's also more environmentally friendly than its competitors. But here's where things get interesting. Sulfur packs more energy per gram than cobalt, and it's much lighter. That's a big deal for EVs and drones where every ounce matters. In theory, lithium sulfur batteries could store way more energy than lithium ion. The problem? Reality quite hasn't caught up to theory. The idea of lithium sulfur batteries dates back to 1962, when researchers patented the chemistry. But despite its promise, the formula had some serious issues that left it collecting dust for decades. The biggest problem? Polysulfide shuttling. I told you we'd get back to that. And during discharge, the sulfur cathode creates polysulfides, which are pesky little molecules that dissolve into the electrolyte and slowly destroy the battery's effectiveness. Worse, some of these polysulfides react with the lithium to form rock-hard crusts around the anode, blocking ion flow and killing the battery entirely. And the bad news doesn't stop there. Slow charge and discharge rates meant lithium sulfur batteries took forever to power up. Dendrites, or metal spikes that can form on the lithium anodes, pose a risk of short circuits impacting battery stability and safety. And then there's swelling issues. As sulfur absorbs lithium, it expands, sometimes so much that it literally bursts the casing. With all of these problems, lithium sulfur batteries were mostly just a lab curiosity, until 2009. That's when the University of Waterloo team found a way to cage sulfur in a carbon framework, preventing swelling while improving stability. Fast forward to 2020, and Monash University made a breakthrough, a special binding agent that gave sulfur extra elbow room, pushing lithium sulfur batteries to 200 charge cycles. And that might sound unimpressive, but for lithium sulfur, it was a huge step. Then in 2021, Monash literally sweetened the deal by adding sugar. This blocked polysulfides from escaping, boosting the battery to 1,000 cycles with a respectable 700 milliamp hours per gram capacity. In 2022, well, it's a banner year for lithium sulfur research. Monash, the University of Michigan, and Drexel University all made breakthroughs using Kevlar fibers, gamma phase sulfur, and other materials to extend the battery life. Drexel even managed to quadruple the lithium sulfur cycle life to 4,000 cycles by accident. I've got a whole video on that and an interview as well if you want to check that out. So with all these improvements, where does that leave lithium sulfur today? Let's dive into the latest breakthroughs. But before we go traveling around the world to learn more about these breakthroughs, there's something else that's extremely useful when traveling. That's today's sponsor, Saley. It's an incredible new eSIM service app because if you've ever been lost abroad or badly needed an internet connection with no Wi-Fi in sight, you'll understand what a difference a local SIM card can make. Because an eSIM provides an internet connection wherever you travel and saves you a ton of money on roaming fees. And you can buy the data that you want Saily lets you choose from multiple affordable eSIM plans in over 180 countries. You can get tons of data and never have to worry about being in an unfamiliar location, not being super fluent in the language, and struggling to get online to find your hotel and your directions. That happened to me on a trip I took to Mexico last year, and I swore I would never end up in that position again. I'm planning a possible trip to the UK and Denmark in a couple of months, and I'm definitely going to be using Saily for that trip. Plus, with the Saily app, getting an eSIM couldn't be simpler. You just buy a plan and activate it, all on the Saily app or website. And once you've got it activated, you're good to use the internet wherever you go without needing to pop into a cafe and pray they have Wi-Fi. And the Saily eSIM plans are compatible with iOS and Android devices, but you'll also get a free refund if it doesn't work on your device. Get an exclusive 15% discount on Saily eSIM data plans. Download the Saily app and use code UNDECIDED at checkout. A Saily eSIM really is a traveler's best friend. Thanks to Saily and to all of you for supporting the channel. So let's get to the latest breakthroughs. We've already talked about Monash University, but they're not done yet. Their latest focus? Polysulfides, the ultimate battery buzzkill. This time, they took inspiration from an unlikely source, betadine, the antiseptic. Betadine contains polyvinyl pyrrolidone. And for my sake, let's just call it PVP. And now I'm thinking about playing Call of Duty. Anyway, in a lithium-sulfur battery, PVP acts as a catalyst, speeding up chemical reactions. Faster reactions means faster charging and discharging. Monash isn't thinking small. They claim their improvements could boost lithium-sulfur energy density to 400 watt-hours per kilogram, blowing past lithium ions, typical 150 to 235 watt-hours per kilogram. That could mean EVs with a 600-mile range or 1,000 kilometers and faster recharging times. Co-author of the paper, Petar Jovanovich, described the potential of the breakthrough as, "This represents a major breakthrough towards making lithium sulfur a feasible option not just for long-haul EVs, but particularly in industries like aviation and maritime that require rapid, reliable power that is crucially lightweighted." Still in Australia, the University of Adelaide may have cracked the fastest charging lithium sulfur battery yet. Their secret? Fixing the sulfur reduction reaction, or SRR. It's a necessary but painfully slow process that also happens to create polysulfides. Their solution? Nanotech. Of course. They landed on a cobalt-zinc nanocomposite electrocatalyst, which sounds like Star Trek technobabble, but basically it supercharges sulfur reactions while keeping polysulfides in check. The result? A lithium-sulfur battery that lasts 1,000 cycles and can charge in just 5 minutes. Gauge warp speed. Over in South Korea, the Daegu Jeonbuk Institute of Science and Technology, or DGIST, took another approach to tackling lithium-sulfur battery weaknesses, graphite scaffolding. Echoing that water loop breakthrough in 2009, DGIST is experimenting with scaffolding to keep those polysulfides contained. The researchers developed ZIF-8, a graphite-based nitrogen-doped material. Again, it sounds complex, but it's actually kind of simple. Let's break down the two main components. Graphite is a very good conductor that shouldn't surprise anybody. Nitrogen is the real secret sauce here. At high temperatures, the nitrogen reacts with the magnesium to form an especially strong and stable carbon structure that helps to keep the sulfur from swelling. Meanwhile, the pore structure helps speed up sulfur loading, allowing the battery to charge super fast. The result? A battery that charges in 12 minutes without turning into a molten death trap. Even at rapid charging speeds, it holds 705 milliamp hours per gram, and DGIST claims that this is a 1.6-fold improvement over conventional batteries, but this isn't stated in the paper itself. And now for the showstopper, a lithium-sulfur battery that could last forever. Okay, not literally forever, but how long is forever? A new study in Nature showcased an all-solid-state lithium-sulfur battery that can cycle 25,000 times while still retaining 80% of its capacity. The key here is the solid electrolytes, which, if you recall from my many previous videos, tends to help promote battery safety and energy density. But solid-state lithium-sulfur batteries have a big weakness, the solid-solid sulfur redox reaction, or SSSRR. To speed things up, researchers added iodine to the mix. And this wasn't an effort to treat a bad cut. Iodine can undergo reversible redox reactions, which lets the battery skip the line when transporting charge. The result? A lithium-sulfur battery with an insane lifespan, still going strong at room temperature after 25,000 cycles and lasting 3,500 cycles even at 60 degrees Celsius. And while this is very cool, and it feels like you're going to start seeing lithium-sulfur batteries on your store shelf any day now, I want to pull the reins just a little bit. These batteries aren't without their flaws, and there's still some significant hurdles to overcome. So what are the hurdles keeping lithium-sulfur batteries from taking over? Well, first off, they're still stuck in the lab. The road from research paper to real-world product is long and bumpy, and many promising technologies never make it past this stage. Even if one of these breakthroughs reaches commercialization, there's another challenge: lithium ion's stranglehold on the market. Lithium ion has been the dominant battery tech for decades, powering everything from phones to EVs to medical devices. Even if lithium sulfur batteries do prove superior, switching over won't happen overnight. Infrastructure, supply chains, and manufacturing lines would all need major overhauls. That said, there's real momentum. Monash University told Cleantechnica they're so confident in their lithium sulfur tech that they plan to do tests in commercial drones and eVTOL aircraft within a year. And with all the buzz around drones for both private and defense sectors, they're bound to attract interest. Speaking of commercialization, we have to mention Lighten. Last time we checked in, the California-based company was developing graphene-cage lithium-sulfur batteries to stop polysulfide issues. Their tests were promising enough that they started building a pilot plant capable of producing over 250,000 cells per year. They also claim to have converted the facility from lithium-ion to lithium-sulfur production in just 6 weeks for less than 2% of the total capital cost. If true, that's a huge point in favor of lithium-sulfur adoption. But Lighten isn't stopping there. They recently announced plans for a billion-dollar gigafactory in Reno, Nevada, set to produce 10 gigawatt hours of lithium-sulfur batteries annually. Phase 1 is expected to go online by 2027, so we may not have to wait too long to see if they can deliver. A lot of battery breakthroughs never make it out of the lab, but this time, things feel a little different. Lithium-sulfur has gone from scientific curiosity to something that actually has a path to commercialization. Will it replace lithium tomorrow or even this year? No, but the potential is so great, they're worth keeping up with. So where does it land on the NASA technology readiness scale? It's complicated. The lab work from Monash, Adelaide, and DGIST is promising, but still very early stage. Meanwhile, Lighten's gigafactory plans push them much closer to commercialization. That puts things maybe at a TRL of 8. For now, we'll have to wait and see if lithium sulfur lives up to the hype. But what do you think? Does this battery have a shot, or is it just another one to add to the research pile? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to listen to my follow-up podcast, Still to Be Determined, while we'll keep this conversation going. Thanks as always to my patrons for your continued support and helping to keep the channel going. Keep your mind open, stay curious, and I'll see you in the next one.